Welcome to WebSense Pro. I'm your host Bilal Nasir. Today we are with another tutorial video, and in today's video we will connect SSH, and we are using WPEngine hosting. So if you don't know what is WPEngine, WPEngine is a managed WordPress hosting provider. They only provide managed WordPress hosting, and their servers are very fast. If you put up your WordPress website on their server, it's going to be very fast and it will be very secure. So this video is not sponsored by WPEngine. I recently got a project about transferring about 100 websites from a custom built server to WPEngine due to some issues which were they having. So I thought to create some of the tutorial videos for you guys. So in first video, we'll learn how to connect SSH in our WPEngine. So without further ado, let's get into it. So guys, first step to open a command line prompt and add this command to your command prompt. So let's open it up. And before adding this command, make sure you have this folder root properly added. What you will need is check if you have .ssh folder existed there. So make sure you are in users and your current user. So in my case, Bilal is the current user, and I'm in this applying this command to this directory. So make sure you check that out, and after making sure that you have this directory by going to your PC, C, users, Bilal, and then .ssh, you should have this folder existed already on your Windows. So I'm currently using Windows 10 to perform this tutorial. And now let's copy this command and paste it on your command prompt. I'll add all of the instruction in the video description so you guys won't have to type it in manually. Okay, now paste it and hit enter. Okay, now it's asking for passphrase. Just add a blank passphrase. You can add a passphrase if you want to. Okay, now our public key and private key is generated. So if I minimize the command prompt, you can see in .ssh folder we have our public key and we have our private key. Now you will need to go to your WPEngine dashboard and click on the user and then profile. So we are currently on our second step where we are adding fingerprint in our WPEngine profile. We did the first step, now we are on the second one where we are adding the fingerprint in your WPEngine profile and then SSH keys. Now click on create SSH key and now go back to your SSH folder, open up the public key. So I'm gonna open it on Notepad++. You can open it on Visual Studio or any other IDE which you have. Now copy this public key and paste it on this section and click on add SSH key. Okay, once your SSH key is added, you can try connecting to your SSH key. So guys, this is the test install which I have created in WPEngine. And that's how the dashboard in WPEngine looks like after creating the new WordPress install. And that's how the backend of WordPress dashboard looks like. Now, after adding the fingerprint, we will create a config file in our SSH folder, because if we don't create the config file, our SSH key won't work. So let me show you guys an example of what error you will get if you don't add the config file. So that's the command which we will use to connect to our SSH. Now we will change environment to our WPEngine stall name. So for example, we need to connect this website via SSH, and the stall name for this is test SSH, or you can say environment name. You can copy this from here or you can copy it from here. As you can see, we can see our SSH login. So let's copy it from here and go back to your command prompt, type in SSH, and then paste what you copied from your WPEngine dashboard. Now hit enter. Are you sure you want to continue? Yes, I want to continue. And now, as you can see, it says permission denied, public key. Now, in order to assign the permission, we'll have to create a config file. And now let's create a config file. Let's open up a new file in Notepad++ and copy this and paste it on our new file and save it on our SSH folder. So I'm going to go back to C, users, below, and .ssh, and save it as config. Make sure to do not add any extension like .txt or .php, anything like that. Just simply add it as config. Now hit save. And as I can see, it's added as .txt. So I'm going to go back to my SSH folder and remove the .txt extension. Okay, we are good with that. Now try connecting again. Let's close the command prompt and reopen it to make sure everything works well. Now type in SSH and wrong command. So let me copy the command again from our dashboard, SSH login, copy, go back to command prompt, SSH, and then paste, hit enter. Now it will, here we go. We are connected via SSH in our WordPress install. We can add commands to deactivate the plugins, to delete the plugins. We can also add the config file. We can do a lot of stuff using CLI commands, which I will teach you guys in the next video. So make sure to subscribe to the channel, comment on the video below, and let me know what else you would like to learn in WordPress, Shopify, or any other topic related to web designing and development. Meanwhile, have a great day.